Welcome. Today we're flying the LEEHY 5 RNAV Arrival and ILS approach to runway 34 right at the Salt Lake City International Airport in Salt Lake City, Utah. Let's take a look at the RNAV Arrival. The first area we can check are the notes and textual description of the arrival. We've checked the weather and will be landing north. The arrival routes from the southeast of the airport, so we can expect runway 34 right. For 34 right, the note says to intercept the ISLC localizer. So we'll make sure the FMC is set up to do that. Our flight plan has us join the arrival at Meeker. As you can see, there is an expect 16,000 feet at Spain. It's good practice to enter expect altitudes in the box anyway. We can always remove them later if needed. Blup has an at or above 12,000 feet, and camp is at 11,000 feet. And here's an additional note stating to intercept the localizer after plage. The chart illustrates the high terrain around the airport, so we'll make sure terrain mode has been selected. We're now inside of Meeker, descending on the arrival using VNAV path. This is a great time to review the ILS approach. Frequency is 109.5. 344 degrees inbound. 6100 at Chevel. Decision altitude is 4,425 feet. The touchdown zone elevation is at 4,225 feet. MSA is 12,700 feet to the south, 11,000 feet to the north and northeast, and 8,600 to the west. If we go missed, we'll climb to 9,000 feet and head out to Ogden and hold as published. The highest terrain is at 11,379 feet and is east of the airport. The runway has ALSF2 lighting system and PAPI on the left side of the runway. To fly this approach with full runway lights, we need a runway visual range of 1,800 feet or half a mile visibility. The runway is 12,002 feet long. We'll make a left turn off the runway. No hotspots or runways to cross from 34 right to our gate. Once we enter moisture, we turn on the engine anti-ice. Descending through flight level 180, we can switch from standard altimeter setting to the local altimeter setting, extend the HUD, and turn on the landing and taxi lights. We're getting lower, so let's watch and follow the arrival and approach in real time. I'll interject occasionally. Attention is given to make sure we are on the VNAV path. We also check for traffic and monitor for high terrain. Once cleared for the approach, we set the final approach fix altitude. We'll use VNAV for now, and arm approach mode prior to reaching the fix. Don't forget, despite the altimeter showing us at over 9,000 feet, the airport elevation is at 4,225 feet. The lower air density may also make it harder to slow down, so we'll take that into account when configuring. Since the gear can be extended at 270 knots, this can be a great option if extra drag is needed to slow the aircraft, so flaps can be introduced. The final approach fix is our next waypoint, so approach mode is armed. With flaps at 5 degrees, the aircraft can be slowed to 180 knots, as it's above the minimum flaps 5 speed. Once at flaps 15, V approach can be bugged, which is our flaps 30 reference speed, plus 5 knots. When we're finished with the flight spoilers, they are armed, so they'll extend on landing. The missed approach altitude can be set, once we're established on the ILS. Selecting the second autopilot channel will enable the aircraft to autoland. It's good practice to recall the steps if a missed approach is necessary. We can see the runway, but an aircraft or airport vehicle could enter the runway by mistake and cause an incursion, requiring us to go around, so we'll be ready just in case.
Minimums 200 minimums 100 50 40 30 20 10
That concludes our look at the RNAV arrival and ILS approach to runway 34 right in Salt Lake City. Please click on like if you enjoyed. Please consider subscribing. And please comment on what you'd like to see in future videos. Thank you.